Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 13.2.2 has been out for a few days. I've been using it primarily on my iPhone 11 Pro and my 12.9-inch iPad Pro from 2018. And it's been a pretty good experience. There are a lot of things that are fixed, but there's also some other problems that not only myself is experiencing, but other people are experiencing as well. So I wanted to talk about my experience, then I'll talk about your experience based off the YouTube community poll, then we'll take a look at the poll, and then also read some of your comments as well. Now, the first thing is RAM management, or apps closing in the background. That has been fixed with this particular update. In fact, it's much, much better, especially on an iPad. So if you're using an iPad or an iPad Pro like this one, and apps were closing in the background when you were trying to multitask, and then maybe you go back into YouTube and YouTube would reload, for example, now only the refresh is happening. It's not reloading the entire app every time. So this is a much better experience. So you can go into anything from, say, the App Store, and you'll see the App Store is reloading, but I have not had it open for a very long time. So when I go back into the App Store, or maybe I go back into YouTube, you'll see YouTube did not reload. So for me, this is a major positive for the last update. Now, there are a few of you saying it's still an issue, but we'll talk about that in a moment. And then also the number one issue I had was LTE switching, or switching when we went from Wi-Fi to LTE. What would happen is I would completely lose all connection. So I wouldn't be able to load any websites, music wouldn't play, podcasts wouldn't play. And maybe I'd go into YouTube, for example, and you'll see it's loading now, and it just loaded my subscription feed. So it's working fine, and it's finally back to what it was like, well, I guess before iOS 13, because I had this problem as well on my iPhone XS Max once we went to the 13 release. So it's finally fixed. Now, for people still having an issue with RAM management and LTE connections, what I would suggest, and this is what I had to do, is after I actually updated, it wasn't fixed. Then I did a hard reset. So what that means is not wiping the phone, but forcing the phone to turn off. So on an iPhone 11 Pro Max, for example, there's a couple ways to do it, but Apple says volume up, volume down, then hold the power button. And if you keep holding, it will force it to shut off and then reboot. And then after it reboots, that problem was fixed. So if you're having any of these weird random bugs, the phone heating up or anything like that, I would suggest you hard reboot the phone. And if you have just a normal phone or an iPhone with a power button and a home button, hold both of those together. I have separate videos on how to do hard resets, but it's something I would highly recommend if you're having those bugs. Now, as far as issues with this, I actually really have not had any issues on my devices now that they're updated. So I've had a pretty positive experience overall. However, my wife has an iPhone 10, and I've talked about her phone a little bit in the past, but the one thing she was having problems with is mail. And the one thing she had a problem with is flagging mail. So for example, if I go into mail, and then maybe I'm in this particular mail here for Microsoft, and I go to flag it, when you go to actually flag something, you've got a choice of colors. And that's something my wife was doing. She was selecting different colors. Well, one thing she noticed is it would always default back to red. It would just go back to red every time. So she could set it to green and start categorizing them, and they would default back to red over and over. So she's having that issue. We'll report it, but it's just an odd issue, something we've noticed. But for all of us in my family, as well as many of you, the performance on this particular update has been outstanding. There's really been no slowdowns except for a few people. And scroll speeds, apps opening, switching between different things, going to different feeds. You'll see it's loading off LTE. My signal's not so great right here where I'm at currently, but overall it's pretty good. I've had no issues whatsoever, so I'm really happy with this update. And that leads me on to battery life. Now, battery life I noticed last night before I went to bed, and I went to bed pretty late or early in the morning, I suppose. I had 50% of my battery life left. However, my usage was not that high. So let's take a look at the usage. And battery health on my 11 Pro Max is 100%. This is my full-time phone. But you'll see here's my usage for today. 3 hours and 22 minutes, 1 hour and 31 minutes of screen off time. Most of that is Twitter and using social media and messaging. And I only use 25% of my battery life. So I'm actually pretty happy with that. That means that if we do the math here, we're at 10 to 12 hours of screen on time on my 11 Pro Max. Now, this is going to vary depending on which device you have, what apps you have installed, how you use it, if you're playing games that rely heavily on processing power, which will drain the battery quicker. So it just depends on how you're using it. But for most people and most people in the comments, you've said that it's great. With the exception of one device, and it seems like the iPhone 7 and 7 Plus seem to have more issues than others. So we'll take a look at the comments in a moment, but a lot of you were saying that we're having issues were on those devices. Now, if we move over to what you've been saying based off the comments, I compiled all of the comments. I read all of them. We'll talk about that in a moment, but I read all of them and then compiled the information and saw what you had to say the most. And most of you say that RAM management has been fixed. There are only a few of you saying that apps are still closing in the background, but most are saying that it's back to normal. Also, I would say about 50% of you are saying battery is fantastic, and then 50% of you are saying it's not so great. And again, I would suggest hard resetting the phone if you're having an issue. Also, many people are saying touch is more responsive. So if you were having touch issues before, that should be better. And then also, some are saying notifications aren't notifying them. So notifications may not be dinging or making a sound even when the phone is not silenced, and then others are just saying that they're not showing up. I actually haven't had this issue, but I've seen a few of you say this, so I wanted to bring it up and just let you know. Now, a few of you have been saying that VoiceOver for accessibility isn't working properly sometimes, and that's newer. Apple's really been pushing pretty heavily with accessibility, and I believe they still have a little ways to go, but that is still a bug for some people. However, based off all the feedback that I read, I would definitely recommend updating if you haven't already. If you're on an earlier version of iOS 13, this seems to be the most stable version of iOS 13 so far. Now let's take a look at the YouTube community poll. Now the YouTube community poll at this point has 17,000 votes. So I really appreciate that. 506 comments. When I compiled the comments, we were almost at 500. So it took me a while to go through all of them, but I've read every single one of them. And I wanted to talk about how many times people mentioned different problems. So 183 times battery was mentioned. And like I said, about 50% of you said it was good. 94 times RAM management was mentioned, and over 90% of you said that it was good or fixed. 20 times mail was mentioned as having problems, but that's not very many in the scheme of 500 comments. And 3 times people mentioned app crashes, and then 17 times people mentioned the phone getting hot or an iPad getting hot. And like I said, if it's getting overly hot when you're just doing simple tasks and not gaming or doing something intensive, I would recommend that hard reset and see if that helps. Now, I wanted you to take a look at one other thing I compiled here on the left. As you see, before we take a look at the comments, on the left, here are all the different devices that you're using based off the comments. So these 500 comments, here are all the devices that I was able to get from those of you that actually mentioned those devices. Now, in this poll, over 17,000 of you voted, which is just incredible to me in 24 hours time about. So I really appreciate that. 58% of you said it was great. 4% said terrible, 18% said okay, but some bugs. Only 8% of you are on the beta, 13.3 beta, and 12% of you use Android. So again, as I say every time, I really appreciate those that are using Android and stopping by an iOS video. So let's take a look at some of these comments. Like I said, there's 506 and quite a few of them. I really appreciate that, but let's go to oldest first, and then we'll read some of these. Battery on my iPhone XS Max is fantastic. RAM management is working great again. Battery on iPhone 7 Plus still not improved. And this is where I keep seeing people with iPhone 7s having a problem. And if you remember a few updates back, Apple actually didn't push the update for iPhone 7 or 7 Plus. There's something different about it. What it is specifically, I don't know. Maybe a chipset, or maybe because they changed to no headphone jack, there's something different about it. So I'm not sure what that is, but that's where I see most of the issues with battery. It's nice on my iPhone XR. I get around 5 to 6 hours of screen on time with heavy usage, which is actually quite good on that phone. iPhone XS running great, but phone gets a little hot. It's really the best update since iOS 13 has been released. Everything works smooth like butter, iPhone 8. Battery life still not good on my 11 Pro Max. And that's where I said the 11 Pro Max, most people are saying it's fantastic. So I guess it just depends on the phone. It's okay for me, but bad battery. I'm on 100%. I think you mean battery health for the iPhone 8. Excellent battery life. I am on iPhone 11. Great using on my iPhone 10. Using on iPhone 7 feels snappier than before, but I'm noticing some minor bugs that are here since iOS 13. RAM management seems to be fixed and battery life is okay. Keep up the great videos. Thank you. I am on iPhone 7. Battery is not as good and I tend to have a lot of issues around stability of my cellular data. It lags a lot without any known reason. 13.2 was okay, but the update made my cellular data very laggy and unstable. My iPad Air 3 has been fine. I wouldn't update my iPhone 7 Plus because of terrible reports of battery life. Staying on 13.1.2 until there's a more reliable report for that device. iPhone 6s Plus, very fast draining battery, and also if I enable my data connection, I did not receive a text. And if I disable my data, then all the text messages, I think you're saying, are coming in. And please fix the battery issues. Like I said, it's very random and hit or miss. I would say the older the device, the higher the chance of you having some issues with battery. Some of that could be due to battery wear or degradation with the battery health over time. Others could be that they're just not paying as much attention to the older devices. It's hard to say, though. Big improvement over 13.2 on my SE and Mini 4. Multitasking seems to be back to normal. I use an iPhone 11 Pro and an iPad 11 Pro. One instance recently of connectivity issue, but apart from a lot of updates recently, no major dramas. Sometimes my AirPods won't connect until I put them back in the case. Some apps still reload from time to time, but it's far better than what it used to be before. I was a beta tester for iOS 13 before the first GM, and the RAM issue was since day one, as far as I can remember, and I reported it many times to Apple. They fixed it when major outlets spoke out about it. That's definitely true. It took quite a few people speaking out about it, I think, to get it fixed, but I'm glad they fixed it now. The AirPods issue I actually have with my Mac. When I try to connect it to my Mac, sometimes it doesn't want to connect properly. Most of the time it's fine, though. Battery life on my iPhone 11 Pro Max is great. The app refresh issue is fixed. Battery draining on 10R very quickly. iPhone 10, battery life still not as good as per iOS 12, sub 6 hours. Native Mail app works much smoother. Overall stability is best in iOS 13 so far. RAM management still suffers, especially at YouTube. I use an iPhone SE. Battery drain is very fast. Had issues with Twitter refreshing itself while using the app. That could be a Twitter issue, though. Photos app is not scanning people's faces right. Actually, it doesn't scan anything after I factory reset my iPhone 10. That actually takes time. That can take a lot of time, and you need to have your phone plugged in, usually overnight, and it just takes a lot of time depending on how many photos you have. If you reset your phone, it has to start from scratch and rescan all of the faces because it's actually stored on the phone itself. They don't send it off to the cloud, such as Google Photos does, for example. I'm using iPhone 8 Plus. Everything seems fine. No lockups. 6S seems fine. Zero lockups. RAM management is better than before. iPhone XR. Battery drain seems worse. Otherwise, haven't noticed any bugs yet. Running it on my iPhone 6S, no bugs or issues encountered so far. Battery performance has improved when compared to the previous version of iOS 13. 3D touch tasks like getting into the multitasking by 3D touching the left edge of the screen and other 3D options isn't working as expected. I have to press a lot harder than before to get it to work. Haptic touch is working fine. But that's it for iOS 13.2.2. I would expect iOS 13.3 beta 2 sometime this coming week. And as far as anything else, we're not really sure what's going to be in 13.3. I wouldn't expect any major changes, but you never know with Apple. They could have a couple things that they're planning. And also maybe those AirTags we'll see eventually that allow you to locate different things, such as those tiles that are currently sold. But we haven't seen much of that yet. But if you've found anything else or if you've seen anything I haven't mentioned, please feel free to comment in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll leave it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.